Excuse me. Sir, sorry to disturb you, but yoo-hoo. Can you hear me?
3, 2, 1, contact, and we have liftoff. Oh, holy mother. A dame. A pretty dame on the launch pad.
Please, no need to worry, sir. Just do stay calm. I just want some information.
Watch what you're doing, sweetheart. We ain't got no information, no strategies, no plans to tell anyone anywhere, anytime. Military regulations, you dig it, babe?
I was going to... Oh, forget it, it doesn't matter. He's too drunk to help anyone anyway.
I am not drunk. I have drunk.
A little.
Strange. Sure, I left a bottle or two around here. I gotta get some air. Wall's getting pretty tight. We'll think about that blast off later, huh?
Are you okay, Colonel? Are you sure you're all right? Be careful! Don't lean out too far, or you'll...
Hey, what's happening? That's water you got there. Stop it! Now! You want me to drown?
Calm down, it's all right. Just a little wake-up call, that's all. You must have had quite a bit to drink.
Gee, you're right there. Not the first time, either. Probably won't be the last. Man, my head. Please, could you whisper?
Please, do excuse me. But it was the only way I could think of to bring you back to your senses.
A little extreme, maybe. I get the impression you're a lady who likes to see results.
Does Aralbad mean anything to you?
Aralbad. It's been a long time since I heard that name. It's a spa resort, man. Top brass of the regime would go there. As well as convalescing soldiers, tired politicians, profiteers and racketers, the whole caboodle. Go live it up, all expenses paid. One privilege I never got. Just two steps away from becoming the nation's hero, and no free holiday for me.
And where exactly is this place?
Further east. We never had to know where exactly. The airship was programmed to take vacationers there. From here.
I came here by train, but unfortunately it broke down. I've got to get to Aralbad immediately. Someone told me you might have a vehicle to lend me.
Someone? Who might that someone be? I hope you're not talking about Sergei Borodin.
Well, yes, I am. The director of the industrial complex below.
Be careful, ma'am. He is not a rational man. He can be mean and very dangerous.
He suggested I come and see you, actually. But I get the impression that he doesn't care much for you, either.
I don't care what he thinks of me. All I say to you is, watch out for him.
There aren't many vehicles on this base.
When they decided to close the Cosmodrome, they towed all the useful equipment away.
It doesn't matter. I'll find some other way.
If I can help you, please, just ask.
I'm looking for someone. Hans Vorarlberg, and I think he came by here about 20 years ago.
Hans? You want to know if I know Hans? But of course. He invented one of the most incredible flying machines of the Cosmodrome. Christmas, good old Hans. Even after that dumb and dirty trick he played on me. But I wouldn't give to see him again.
What do you mean? What did he do to you?
Hans Vorarlberg and his famous flying wing. See, he invented this kind of spring-loaded launcher, capable of projecting a weird rocket into the stratosphere. It was red revolutionary hot, and I was going to be its first test pilot. Holy cow, what a job. And then several days before the launch, Hans disappears into thin air like that, poof. The test program? Well, it's abandoned.
Just disappeared like that? Without saying where he was going?
You see, he wanted to hit the stars, but not bombs, if you get my drift. One day, Hans finally worked out what his launcher was really for. So the generals have always called the shots here, you realize, and when they asked Hans to screw a nuclear warhead onto his flying wing, well, he wasn't a happy man. So he left, just like that.
If everything was ready, why didn't you just wind the thing up and go flying after all?
Nobody understood machines here like Hans, especially not his own utopian inventions. You see, such inventions only live and breathe with their creator in the saddle. Without him,
space travel became damn near impossible. And since then? Well, I still like to travel, but in my own little way.
I'm beginning to understand a bit about how Hans Vorarlberg's inventions work. What is this one like?
I don't really know. As you can see, I'm a soldier, ma'am. Nothing more, nothing less. I'm not a goddamn aerospace engineer.
Don't you find it strange to see so many birds in the Cosmodrome?
It's the iron rafters. I love them. Nowadays, they can enjoy a bit of good old peace and quiet here. So, of course, they turn up in flock loads. Sometimes I set Soyuz onto them. Just like the good old days.
Soyuz?
Soyuz is the last Golden Eagle left in active service. We had to get the dumb canaries out of the way before takeoff, so what did we do? Set the Eagle on them. And you should see them fly. Soyuz? He's like a cat among the pigeons. Magnificent.
My name is Kate Walker. I'm a lawyer currently in charge of a special case. I'll spare you the details, but I've landed here, you see, unintentionally.
It is indeed an honor to welcome you here to the Cosmodrome, ma'am. My name is Colonel Boris Sharov. I'm a Red Army test pilot reject. Now I babysit the Kumkalsgrad space complex.
This is an amazing complex. Shame it's a little run down.
What do you expect? Space race is yesterday's news. That's the way it is. News one minute, history the next.
Thank you so much for helping me. I'm sorry to have woken you up like that.
It's been great talking to you, ma'am. I think I'll take 40 winks right now.
I need a key. Sir? Sir?
My head. Oh, my poor head. I need some quiet. Please, can I have some quiet?
Do you think the airship still works?
No idea. It has been so long since it was used.
And then I've got to learn how to use it, too.
You won't have any worries there. It has an automatic pilot. Go visit if you want. Here's the key.
Thanks. Right, I'm off. See you later.
Don't you worry about me.
Doesn't look like that works. There you are. I was looking for you. I've managed to trigger the autopilot mechanism, but the airship still won't take off. Do you know why?
Maybe. I've got some idea. But you look like you're a pretty good mechanic.
Let's just say that since the start of the journey, I've managed to get by and get to know Hans Varlberg's strange contraptions.
Okay. I have a deal to make with you. I've been living in this dumb launcher site for years. And I've always said that one of these days I'm going to the stars on that flying wing. And I'd better make that trip before vodka stews my brain. But I gotta know how it works. And you look like you might have some clue at least. If you could help me get to the stars, I'll tell you how the airship works. What do you say? We got a deal?
Why not? I'll see what I can do for you.
Thank you.
Comrade Boris. I need a few drops of your blood.
Excuse me?
To get the centrifuge going, we'll need to analyze the pilot's blood. If you're going to the stars, you've got to be in good health, you see? That's why I need a blood sample. It won't hurt.
There's two things a good soldier is always ready to do. Drop his pants and spill his blood. Go ahead.
I'll only be needing your blood.
My pleasure, ma'am.
Okay, I think I've figured out how it works. Get settled in and let's go. Colonel, are you all right?
Never been better. Head's spinning a bit, but I am used to that. I'm a professional pilot.
Clear as smog. Can you speak up?
I'm ready. Press the launch button.
Takeoff procedure engaged. Countdown commencing.
Colonel, you've forgotten to tell me the secret of the airship. What do I have to do?
Liftoff.